too?
Thousands and thousands.
Same with me. They all hit me up.
It was fucking... I never expected that, man. And that just shows, you know, that people love us, man. People love us, and we really, really fucking... You know, I can't thank everybody, you know, because we're getting thousands and thousands.
60,000 people. When I put a little video letting people know, they all commented and watched.
Yeah, we've been getting thousands and thousands of messages. I can't respond to all of them, you know... But we do appreciate all the love that the fans give us. You know, it's been unbelievable, honestly. You know, we've been getting flowers and flowers to my dad's house. People send them to my house, and then I take them to my dad's. You know, we've had nothing but love. You know, we've had a lot of support, and you know, people show up people send us food. You know, they deliver food to the house because you know my sisters don't want to be cooking right now or anything, so they deliver food, flowers, messages, you know, that I'm getting on social media. It's unbelievable, and you know, for that, you know, I didn't think it was gonna be like that, but I'm telling you, thousands and thousands of messages, and that makes us feel better.
Unfortunately, it was very tragic.
It was.
Because your mom was perfectly healthy, everything was good,
man.
Got COVID, and in 3 weeks, the whole, everything changed.
Sad. 3 weeks, man. She, you know, and the thing is that my mom was, since COVID started that early last year, she was one that was always very careful, always cleaning everything inside her house. There was a day that I had to drop something off for them. I think it was cleaning supplies and stuff like that, like sanitized stuff. I went to my dad's house. And I called my dad, you know, saying, you know, I'm here. So him and my mom, you know, my mom was 70, my dad's 75 at that time, because it was early last year. And they both come out, you know, my parents, they're both, you know, older, you know, getting up there in age. So they both wait for me in the front door. I come to them, I give them their thing. My mom already had her hands so she could clean everything that I, you know, everything that I dropped.
She
sanitized it. And we talked for a little bit, you know, with a little distance. I couldn't even go inside my dad's. I didn't even go inside my parents' house. And that fucking hurt me, you know. Leaving, you know, getting in my car. And I'm 20 minutes from my dad. I'm away home. I cried. I just broke down because it was just hard to see that my parents were there waiting for me, and I couldn't give them a hug. You know what I mean? It sucks. You know. Then little by little, you know, Mikey got it. I got it. My family got it. So since we were my sisters, they've all got it too. Since you know we took the antibody test and we were all positive for that one, which means we can't get. So we started, you know, visiting my parents, but also with, you know, being a little careful. You know, but my mom still got it, you know. She got it sometime, you know, late November. We're thinking maybe Thanksgiving, because I was in Mexico for Thanksgiving. So I wasn't there, but, you know, my sisters came over.
And, you never know. You never know. Could be anything.
It could have been, you know, I think there was a time where she went to the store also with one of my sisters. Maybe she touched something that was, you know, so we don't know. We don't know, but it was, you know, I think I was, because I was in Mexico for Thanksgiving. But the first time, I was at Josecito's fight. My wife and my kids, they ordered the fight on pay-per-view. So Mikey was at my dad's, at my house. Mikey was at my house watching the fight on pay-per-view. I was at Josecito's fight when my sister called Mikey and told him, Mikey, my mom's not doing good. I think we're gonna have to take her to the hospital. So Mikey drove. Mikey didn't even see the main event. Mikey seen Josecito's fight, but he didn't see the main event. Mikey drove to my dad's house. By the time Mikey got to my dad's house, my mom was already gone. They had already taken her to the hospital. So I didn't get to see my mom since, you know, because I was in
Dallas.
In Dallas.
That was Spence, Danny Garcia night.
Yes, I was there. when I got back, you know, it was all through my sister. What have they told her? You know, they're telling her this, they're saying this. They put her on the ventilator. Then there was this one day that it was like 1 week before she passed. The nurses were very nice to my sister, and my sister was also, you know, always very, 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 very kind to them also. So the nurse told my sister that she would try to do like a Zoom meeting so we could see my mom.
Yeah.
My dad was telling me yesterday, actually, my dad, you know, he says that you know, the last time before she died, the last time my dad seen her when she left the hospital, that it was my dad and my sister Jackie. You know, they walked her out to the ambulance, and then when she was already in the inside the ambulance, that the last thing she did was you know, that she said bye, and that she gave him like blessing. She blessed my dad and my sister, and my dad, you know, that gets my dad, you know, sad. So, you know, he started cheering when he was telling me that's the last thing, you know, when she left in the ambulance, that she did a little cross, and, you know, like
goodbye.
Bye.
Yeah.
Then I'm gonna go back to when we went through the Zoom video. We all got the code, you know, so my brother Danny, my nieces in San Jose, everybody, you know, that, you know, family, the kid, the sons and the grandkids. So they we all had different little groups, and we were at my dad's house. This was the day before they put her on the ventilator. So she still had one of those machines right here for the air. But, and she was still talking. So she was recognizing everybody.
Yeah.
You know, seeing us on the, she was in bed.
Yeah.
She was in bed, but they had a laptop in front of her. So she could see everybody that was talking to her. So that was the last time we talked to her. You know, we all told her, you know, be strong, you're gonna make it, we love you. And she said, one thing she said was, she says, this is so painful. She told us, this is so painful. So we didn't know if she meant, if she was in pain or it was painful to see us.
Correct, yes.
Fucking computer.
I understand.
So that's one thing we still don't know if she meant.
Physical pain or emotional?
Or
yeah.
Emotional, seeing us through a fucking laptop. So, you know, that was the last time we talked to her. Then a week later, you know, is when they told us she's getting worse and getting worse. So the doctors and the nurses, they you know, things happen for a reason. They told us, you know what, we're gonna give you guys permission to come and say your goodbyes. So we set everything up at the time, and we all came in. It was eight of us, seven sons, you know, three of us and four sisters, and my dad. It was eight of us. They were not gonna let all of us out. They only said, we can't, you know, it's gonna be four only. So my sisters went in first, and then they came out, and then we went back in. But right there, we told the doctor and the nurse, look, it's her last, you know, her last, let us all be together. And they made that exception.
That's amazing.
You know, they allowed my sisters to come in. So they told us, look, we're gonna give you guys all the time you guys want. You guys can take all the time you guys want. But when you guys are ready, tell us, we need to come in, you know, clean her out, take all the tubes out of her mouth and body. And that's gonna be a two or three minute wait. So we had to step out. So when that happened, we already knew it was her last minutes. They told us it could be up to 2 hours, 3 hours, depending on her body. But her body wasn't leaving she was already leaving through machines. So I actually timed it. The moment we stepped out to when they told us to come back in, it just took 23 minutes. 23 minutes, that's when she took her last breath and declared, you know, that, you know, we are, you know, what was the most beautiful thing that I'm gonna remember? my dad talking to her, bro. Because they told us, your mom could hear you. Because that's the last thing that she couldn't talk to us, she couldn't see us. But they said, but you guys talk to her, she could hear you guys. That's what the doctor told us. So we're all talking to her, you know, telling her we love her. And she was tearing. Wow. That means she did hear us. But when my dad went up, my dad let us do all the talking first, and then he goes right there to her and says, Virginia, this is Eduardo, your husband. I want to thank you. Thank you for 55 plus years living with me. I want to tell you I'm sorry for all the bad things I did. I also forgive you for everything. For everything. But I just want to tell you that those were the best 55 years of my life. And I'm gonna miss you forever. Ain't nobody gonna take your spot in your house. Nobody's gonna get in. Nobody, no other woman's gonna go in there to replace you, to move your decorations. My mom had a lot of decorations. Move your decorations around. That's never gonna be removed. And that was his goodbye. It was hard, Elie. It was hard, but we also have to know that, the way I see it and the way Mikey sees it, my sisters see it a little different. But one day we're all gonna go. We're all gonna go, Some of us go, some go sooner than the others. Some live longer, but we're all going. We're all gonna die one day. So, right now with this pandemic, it's hard because it was this pandemic that took my mom, my dad's aunt that passed away that same week, or his cousin, same thing, so it sucks that this pandemic had to take my mom, but one day we're all going, so we have to live, a happy life. We have to love everybody. We have to tell everybody that we love them. We want to show them in during your life, show them that you love them, and vice versa, let them show you that they love you. When somebody's already in their grave, a lot of people go cry. It's too late.
That's when they give them the flowers. You told me about your wife. Give the flowers when they're alive. But Robert,
my wife doesn't want none of that. My wife, and I think Pita and all of my family, my kids, myself, we agree to that. We want to take my wife flowers. I will take my mom flowers, because I want them to see it. I don't want to do it until they're dead. We all say, when I'm dead, I'm not gonna see that. I'm done already. So do it now. If you love me, visit me now. Call me now and just tell me you love me. And I do the same with people, because life is short, man. Life is fucking short. So with your kids, love your kids, enjoy your kids, enjoy every moment. Because if you go to work, you might not come back.
That's what I was going to say. You guys are very fortunate that you got to say goodbye, especially in a pandemic, because millions of people are by themselves.
They
can't say goodbye.
And then they just turn in their ashes.
That's it.
With us, we were fortunate to be able to be there
and say goodbye.
Minute. It was 23 minutes once they disconnected.
Yeah.
23
until
minutes.
She passed.
We were there to talk to her. We cried, obviously, but we were there to talk to her. We were there to tell her how much we love her. And then they're also gonna let us have the funeral services with restrictions.
Limited, yeah.
But they're not gonna limit people that could come in from two to 6 p.m. at the Garcia mortuary this coming Sunday. They're gonna allow unlimited. But obviously they could come in, pay the respects, and then with distancing. But for those 4 hours, they're gonna allow anybody come in. Obviously then when they do the I don't even know what it's called, man. It's 1 hour of
the wake. mass?
Yeah, like a little mass, rosary, el rosario. It's 1 hour, so there it is only family, you know, the kids, grandkids, brothers, sisters, and only the very close family. That's the only people they're gonna allow there. But throughout the day, they're gonna let everybody come in. Then the following day, when we obviously, you know, we take her, you know, to get buried, they're also gonna have unlimited. They said it's open door, so anybody could be there. So that kind of makes us feel better too. But it sucks, bro. Fucking sucks.
Of course, it's unexpected.
Exactly. Huh?
Danny Jacobs. That was fight of the year.
Was it? No.
No.
I didn't see it.
What?
It was hard, you know, and like, but like I said, like, all the calls, the messages we've been getting on social media, it's unbelievable, man. And we never posted anything before, you know, pray for my mom, all that, because, you know, me and Mikey, my kids, we have a different belief, you know. Everybody, you know, a lot of people believe, you know, that, you know, no, we, you know, science and the doctors, we think, you know, for us, that's, you know, that's the best thing, you know, we're all gonna die one day. And you know, the day that she passed at night, I told people, because people were still calling us, how's your mom?
They didn't know.
So we were already at my dad's house, already, you know, everybody's crying and sad. And I was still getting calls and messages, how's your mom? You know, please let us know. So I told people, you know what, I think it's time that we have
to. You gotta post something.
So we put a picture of my mom, and I didn't want to put a picture of her in the hospital.
No.
None of that, you know, it's all happy pictures with me. You know, the pictures that we were there, you know, it was me and my sister. So, I didn't put, like, you know, with the whole family or anything, because we just didn't have them there. I took it that we have to put something with me. So I told my sister, give me a picture of you know, that you might be with my mom or something. I put one of my wedding, and I said, Pita put something up, you know, letting everybody know. Thousands and thousands of messages. And it's been really nice, man.
Yeah, no, it is. And people are very supportive. Everybody loves you guys. Robert, and now
so there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.